this session we will have the calculations or tutorials as solar cell. It should be the tutorial, but we have just seen that PN junction is solar cell. When you put a light, voltage gets generated, and therefore PN junction behaves as a solar cell. And there are various parameters of solar cell, right, that we have seen yesterday, the short circuit current, open circuit voltage, fill factor. So, let us start looking at the problems. We will look at the problems for calculating the drift current, okay, calculating the diffusion current, calculating I0 will be difficult, but we will try it, absorption coefficient, absorption length, open circuit voltage, short circuit current, and eventually efficiency. So, those are the things we will do. So, one thing that I have told in the morning is that in any semiconductor under equilibrium, that one relationship that is always true is N0 times P0 equal to Ni square. Okay. This is one thing. Always, if I say the doping of boron is stands for 15 atom per centimeter, which means that many holes are created. So, holes, number of holes created is also stands for 15. Okay. If I say doping of phosphorus is stands for 17 atoms per centimeter cube, which means the number of electrons is also stands for 17. Fine. So, note down a problem and do it. A semiconductor is doped with 10^14 boron atom, 10^14 boron atoms, 14 atoms per centimeter cube. Okay. Let's say silicon is doped with boron atoms of 10^14 atoms per centimeter cube. Find out the majority and minority carrier concentration. So, what are the majority carriers? Who holes are majority carriers? So, P0. So, majority. So, what is the majority? 10^14 number per centimeter cube. And what are the minority? So, minority are electrons, and their concentration is 10^6 numbers per centimeter cube. Right? Simple. If the mobility, now the second part of this, mobility of electron in silicon, you know how much it is? We have seen in the last presentation, about 1350, right? Let us say 1400. It should be 10^8, sorry, no, 10^6, that is right. So, Ni is for silicon is 10^10. So, Ni square is 10^20. No, that is not Ni. Ni is intrinsic carrier concentration. Intrinsic carrier concentration for silicon is 10^10 numbers per centimeter cube. Silicon atom density is 5 × 10^22 atoms per centimeter, that is silicon atom density. Ni is intrinsic carrier concentration, so which means intrinsic electron and intrinsic hole concentration is 10^10 per centimeter cube. Okay. So, Ni is intrinsic carrier concentration, which is for silicon, it is 10^10. Numbers per centimeter cube. Okay, so that will give you P0 10^14, that is the majority carrier concentration, that will give you N0 10^6. Okay, so you may have this kind of scenario, right? In general happens that your P side is 10^16, your N side is 10^19. Okay. So, in this case your electrons are majority, that case holes are majority. Once you know the majority carrier at the site, you can find out the minority carrier. Okay, so once you know the majority carrier at a given side, you can find out the minority carrier Ni square by. So take a p-n junction X problem here. Yeah. We'll come back to the mobility thing again. Let us do this again. So right now, don't worry about this part. Okay, right now don't worry about these numbers. Just look at this numbers. So you have p-n junction. Okay, now go next. Okay, now find out the other part. Holes are majority and this minority. So just look at this part. Okay, so then the majority and the minority are electrons. When you go to the other side, you know the number changes. You know, the electrons which were minority here now becomes majority here, and holes which are minority here becomes majority there. So you know this number, you know this number. You find out these two numbers. Okay, simple. How much is so? How is the hole concentration? 10 to the 16. So then n. Electron concentration will be 10 to the 4. Electron concentration is 10 to the 19. So hole concentration here is 10. So let us see another problem. Okay, quickly we will work on many problems. So your piece of semiconductor, which is p type. Okay, doped with the boron. So boron doping is, let's say, 10 to the 16 atoms per centimeter cube, and then you need a mobility of electron mu n is 1350 centimeter square per volt second, and mobility of holes is, let's say, 400 centimeter square per volt second. Find out the conductivity of the semiconductor. Okay. You also need a cross section area, which let's say 1 cm². What you need to do? You need to find out conductivity of semiconductor. So let me introduce M.N. Rao and Amrita Joshi. They are my PhD student. They are here to help you out for your problems. So they will be around. If you need any help, you can take their help. But N and then my mu n. Now what is the conductivity? Plus Q P mu P. Q is charge on electron. 1.6 tens for. This conductivity of electron, but there are holes also, right? So you have to sum it up.
So actually, I can solve it now here. So I can just cross it. Conductivity. Conductivity equation comes out to be Q n mu n plus Q p mu p. So what we have is p type semiconductor. So our minority concentration n comes out to be 10^4 per centimeter cube, as majority concentration p is 10^16 per centimeter cube. So actually we can say this conductivity will be approximately equal to QP mu P value, and we can actually calculate that
because n is very small as compared to p. The first term is going to be negligibly zero, and you can always, in fact, whenever you are talking about the semiconductor with electrons and holes, this always happens. One of the term is going to be small as compared to other terms, so you can directly neglect the first term, and therefore conductivity is just equal to QP mu p.
I can substitute, then it comes out to be 1.6 into 10^-19. P value is 10^16, and mu p value is 400. So we can accordingly get the value. So it will be 6.4 into, this is 18, 19, so 10^0.64. Ohm centimeter. 6.4 × 10^-1.
Per ohm centimeter. Okay, fine. So you can find out the conductivity, whether it's P type or N type or whatever is doping, very simple. You need to know the mobility. You don't need area, by the way, okay? Area is not required. So if a parameter is given, you don't have to necessarily use it. Now let us extend this. Let us go to the second part of this problem.
Yeah, assume for the same conductivity of the material, let an electric field of 1 volt per centimeter is applied across the this P type material. Can you guess what will be the current density? So an electric field of 1 volt per centimeter is applied across this region, P region. So what will be the drift current when electric field is applied? A drift current will result. So what should be the drift current when 1 volt per centimeter of electric field is applied across P region which is having the given dopings?
So what we have as a current density will be sigma into electric field. So sigma value we have already found out to be 0.64, and 1 volt per centimeter is the conductivity. So we will get it to be 0.64 per centimeter square. This is the current density value. So if we have area as it is given in the previous sum, we can actually find out the current value as well.
So if area is 1 centimeter square, then your current, okay, current is 0.64 ampere. Okay, now this 1 volt per centimeter is a small current, small electric field. Typically current electric field can be of much higher, and particularly within the junction, the electric field goes to as high as, I think, 10^5, 10^6 volt per centimeter. It's very high electric field. Okay, so actually 1 centimeter square cross section area can carry a lot of current. This current is very small because electric field is very small here. One volt per centimeter is a small electric field. Okay, fine. Now, so drift is okay. We can find out the drift, electron and hole drift, etc. Now, let us go to the problem with the diffusion. So, the problem with the diffusion is there on your screen? You can read it. Instantaneous carrier concentration in an n-type semiconductor at two points separated by 100 micrometer each from each other are 10^17 per centimeter cube and 10^15 per centimeter cube. If the diffusion coefficient of electron in the semiconductor is 30 centimeter square per second, find out the diffusion current density in the semiconductor. If you have any doubt, Amrita and Rao is here, you can ask them anytime. You know how to approach this problem? You need to find out diffusion current for diffusion current of electrons, right? Electron gradient is given, and you know the diffusion current is proportional to the concentration gradient and diffusion coefficient and charge, right? So you can actually use the expression that we have discussed in the morning before lunch session and find out. It is very easy again. If you need any help regarding anything, you can ask the two TAs here. They will help you out. Is it clear to everybody? Yeah, this is what we need to calculate. The profile, instead of profile, what they have mentioned is two point concentration, two different points which are separated by 100 micrometer. Now they have brought down everything to the centimeter, right? This is per centimeter cube, so this 100 micrometer stands for minus 2 centimeter. And this term is negligible as compared to this term, you know, 100 times smaller, so therefore make it nearly zero. So therefore overall it is stands for 17 by this. So the gradient is stands for 19 per centimeter times 4. Now what they have done is they have used very large number, but if it is a minority carrier concentration, same answer you will get, same answer you can get if the numbers are smaller and the distance is smaller. So if the carrier concentration gradient 100 micron is a very large distance, but if that has to happen in within let's say 0.1 micron, 100 nanometer, this number will go even higher. So the gradient can be higher, but then you can put this here and you can get the diffusion current due to the electron for a given concentration gradient. Okay, what I can say, I can also describe my nx as a function, right? I can say okay, my nx is x square minus 2x plus 10, some function, and then find out the diffusion current. Do it quickly, it's 2 minutes job. So this is my concentration profile now, and as a function of x is given as x square minus 2x plus 10, and find out the diffusion current. So again you find a gradient, okay, so you find a gradient 2x minus 2, but then you have to find the diffusion current. So then J in diffusion is again q d into 2x minus 2. So that's your diffusion current, simple. So basically you need to know the gradient from some way or other. You can have the diffusion profile, or you can have the carrier concentration at two different points, or you can have some expression which is giving you the diffusion profile. Once you do that, you can find out the diffusion current. Okay. So now when there is an electric field as well as there is a concentration gradient, you will have four component of current, right? In the first case, there is only gradient, there is no concentration difference, no gradient, so therefore only drift current. In the second case, this example, there is only diffusion current because there is only there is no electric field, electric field is zero. But there may be example when both diffusion, when there is an electric field as well as the concentration gradient, the current component will be due to both concentration gradient, both diffusion and drift. Fine, it's clear, the diffusion problems. You can find out again the diffusion for the electrons and holes. And so we can actually create more complicated situations in which there is a concentration gradient, there is electric field, and there are minority carrier concentration which is not very small. Minority carrier concentration can also be large and things like that. So depending on the situation, you take appropriate approximations and then solve the problem. Fine? Depending on the situation, take appropriate approximation and then you solve the problem. You need to do a lot of practice, by the way, before get used to it. Okay? Fine. What is next?
So this problem is about absorption. So a beam of photons of 500 nanometer wavelength is falling on a piece of indirect band gap semiconductor. The absorption coefficient of this wavelength of photons is 10 power 4 per centimeter. So what is the maximum distance the photon would be able to travel in the semiconductor before getting absorbed? Yeah, it is very simple. So the probability of interaction of a photon with a semiconductor depends on its wavelength or energy, but it does not depend on intensity. Now I have given you only one photon is incident. A photon of particular wavelength is incident. You can also calculate the energy for the particular wavelength. E is hc by lambda. So if photon of this energy is incident, so it goes through some distance before it gets absorbed in the solar cell or in a material. So that distance you can estimate by inverse, it is inversely proportional to 1 by absorption coefficient. So assume this as a semiconductor. If phi is the flux that is incident on the semiconductor, so by flux I mean the number of photons per unit area per second. So these mean number of photons per unit area per second are incident, and let at the surface the photon density the flux is phi naught. So as it goes through the semiconductor, it will be absorbed and it gets reduced. So it will be in the form of, it reduces in the form of phi naught e power minus alpha x. As we go through the distance, x increases and the phi naught value decreases. The phi value decreases. Mean all these photons are absorbed in the before they travel a distance of L. So when x equal to L, when x equal to 1 by alpha, which is nothing but L, which I have shown, so then phi naught will be, phi will be phi naught e power minus 1 or phi naught by e times. The flux is reduced by e times. That means phi naught minus 1 by phi naught minus the rest of the flux, phi naught minus phi naught by e, is absorbed in this distance L or x equal to 1 by alpha. Am I clear? Or basically, one more point I want to make clear. Absorption depends on absorption coefficient. To what depth a photon travels, we need to consider the absorption coefficient, and it depends, it is property of the material. So the another important mechanism that happens in solar cells is recombination. So the question is like this: the monadic carrier concentration in an n-type material is about 10 power 3 per centimeter cube. Due to the light incident on the material, the minority carrier concentration has increased to 10 power 16. If the excess minority carrier, they travel a distance of 2 micrometer in 2 microseconds before recombining, calculate the recombination rate of minority carriers. Capture coefficient, absorption coefficient. It's not that complex. As light falls, electron hole pairs will be generated. So initially the minority carrier concentration is 10 raised to 3 per centimeter cube. When light is falling, the concentration has increased to 10 raised to 16 per centimeter cube. So these excess concentration will not remain like that. So it will get recombined. And what decides this recombination? So it basically depends on excess carrier concentration. The more the excess concentration, the more the recombination. So I'll show you the equation. So the basic equation, recombination rate is excess carrier concentration by lifetime. Lifetime is the time before which the excess carriers get recombined. So these 10 raised to 16 electrons per centimeter cube, they get recombined after 2 microseconds. So they travel till 2 microseconds and then they recombine. So the recombination rate can be calculated using this. So you might be knowing that recombination is one of the most degradation mechanism that happens in a solar cell. We don't want it to happen, but it happens. But somehow we try to avoid it so that we can improve the efficiency. So these excess carriers that are generated because of light incident, they have to be collected as soon as possible before they get recombined. But in the means of collecting, they have to travel through the semiconductor and they cannot travel more than 2 microseconds, so they get recombined. Before they get recombined, we need to collect them. So we can improve, we can improve the recombination performance if we have more lifetime. And the another term which can be used for this recombination is diffusion length. So diffusion length is the distance the distance the carrier can travel before it get recombined. So both this lifetime and diffusion length, they are the measures of the performance of the device. So the more the lifetime, the more the diffusion length, the better will be the performance of the cell or efficiency of the solar cell. Next problem is about short circuit current density, or the current density that will be produced when light is incident on a solar cell. So when light is incident, you are given that the generation is 10 raised to 20 electron hole pairs per, so carrier generation is 10 raised to 20 electron hole pairs per centimeter cube per second. So because of this generation, we will be having these electron hole pairs are generated, and they need to be collected before they get recombined. So if we can collect them without getting recombined, we will get all the current. But as shown by this equation, so diffusion length, LN and LP play important role in the performance of the device. The carriers, all the carriers that are within one diffusion length will only contribute to light generated current. So you have equation QG LN plus LP plus. It is one of the important parameters for solar cell. And the another important parameter is open circuit voltage. So the expression for that is, so you have already got some light generated current density. Assume J naught, which is called reverse saturation current, as 10 raised to minus 13 ampere per centimeter square, and you can find open circuit voltage for that particular light generated current. So please go on finding, please find open circuit voltage for this generation and this reverse saturation current. And KT by Q you can assume as 2.6. So and the units of KT by Q are, it's volts. KT is electron volts, divided by charge is volts. Ln JL by J naught plus 1. another important parameter for solar cell is fill factor. So it indicates the amount of series resistance and shunt resistance that are happening, that are occurring in the device. So once we know open circuit voltage, short circuit current density and the fill factor, we can proceed finding efficiency of the solar cell. Open circuit voltage is given, short circuit current is also given, and fill factor is given as 75%. So can find efficiency from this equation. For the earlier problem,
Jn is the first value light generated value which we have calculated.
Short circuit current density is same as JL, light generated current.
So we have already calculated VOC, this is some measurement. It is the input, generally according to efficiency, output by input is our formula. So input here is the light incident. So it is the power in the incident light or power radiation. So it is, as it is mentioned, it is standard testing condition. So we can take it 1000 watt per meter square.
Actually, we have units of incident radiation as 100 milliwatt per milliwatt per centimeter square. So we need to find efficiency, we need to use short circuit current density so that we can have consistency in units. VOC is in volts, and JSC, if we consider that in milliampere per centimeter square, and fill factor is not having any units, and the incident radiation is having units of milliwatt per centimeter square. So to maintain consistency, we need to use short circuit current density instead of short circuit current. So assume an area of 1 centimeter square. So this is so as we have milli in both numerator and denominator, we can neglect it. Or if we take, we should take in both numerator and denominator.
Thousand is watt per meter square. When it comes to milliwatt per centimeter square, so it comes to be 100.
Yeah, maintain the consistency of units. If you take meter square, you should also take short circuit current density in meter square, per meter square. So then you can get this value. So this is the final value which you can get. So you should tell. So 12%, approximately 12%. So we are about to close this session. Okay, then we shall leave. Thank you. Thank you very much.